You all right, Phil?
Yeah, I'm just a bit tired, that's all.
Well, don't forget what the doc said. Any sign of fever or headache, go and see him straight away.
Oh, but surely he doesn't think it's going to start again.
Why not? Stranger things have happened. Speaking of strange things.
Now, this, Stevens, is what we laughingly call a work area. I'm sure Smith can find something for you to do.
Oh, Stevens, eh?
Sonia, you must be B. Smith.
Oh, I see. Heard all about me, have you?
Miss Ferguson told me all about you, so you can imagine she said only the nicest things. I'd say she was thinking of you all the time. Isn't that right, Miss Ferguson?
Now, that was a bad start, Stevens. And 15 years is a long time, especially if I'm thinking of you all the time. And I promise you, I will be.
15 years? Good heavens, that's forever. What on earth did you do?
Mind your own business, Pixie.
No, it's all right. You're bound to find out sooner or later.
Oh, good. I must admit I'm a bit curious myself. Heard you bump off?
No, it was nothing like that. I had some love letters belonging to a certain politician. Anyway, to cut a long story short, he called my bluff and the cops at the same time.
Politician, eh? You know, I thought you were a cut above the rest. Okay, lady, she's a bit on the classy side, but the freak doesn't like her, so she's one of us. Say hello to Sonia.
Well, thanks very much, sister. Yes, yeah, I do. Yes, thank you, I appreciate it.
Well?
I give up, Jude. No, I don't mean that. I just mean that I know she's not in any hospital.
Are you sure, Wally? I mean, have you rung them all?
I've rung every hospital in a radius of 50 miles twice. Believe me, I am sure.
Oh, damn it, where the hell is she?
You know what I think? I think she's on a binge.
No, Wally, forget that. Look, I've already been to all of her old watering holes. I've checked with all of her drinking mates. Nothing, zilch. She's just vanished. I mean, there must be something we can do. I practically kicked her out of this place.
Oh, that's rubbish. Look, all you did was tell her off, and I would have done exactly the same thing. What about that husband or whatever he is?
George? She hasn't seen him for months. From what I can gather, he doesn't want to see her. I tell you what I did do. I went to the chemist. I checked on that drug she was taking. What was it called?
Morphalgan.
Yeah. Whatever she's got, she's in a lot of pain. A hell of a lot of pain.
Stand on the white line, will you, please?
Noisy little place. What's all that about?
You'll get used to it. It's the end of work, Belle.
Oh, looks like I arrived at the right time.
Your name is Randy Goodlove, is that correct?
Randy by name, Randy...
Just answer the question, will you? Yes or no?
Well, if you insist, yes, it is.
You've been charged with soliciting and sentenced to 14 days imprisonment. Is that correct?
Impeccably.
Come over here, will you? And give me all your personal possessions. Then you will go to the showers over there, and you'll be issued with a uniform.
Design a label, I hope.
Good love. I've been here for a number of years, and I know all the clever dialogue. It gets rather boring at times. So would you please shut up?
This is going to be a fun-packed fortnight, isn't it?
Another comedian on our hands?
You mean clown, don't you? At least she'll fit in with the rest of the circus in this place.
Anything I should know in those papers?
No, nothing to worry about. I think I might take them through and they can look at the pictures before tea.
I hate to be a bother, but we seem to have run out of soap.
Oh, but
how are they,
Bea? Oh, snoring their heads off. At least Lizzie is. I think Helen was having an R-rated dream. How are you bearing up?
I'm a little tired. I think I'll be in bed straight after dinner.
Just what the doctor ordered, if you know what I mean.
Move. Here you go. Don't fight over them, ladies.
Just been cutting out all the juicy bits again, have we?
Oh, I think there'll be enough there to interest you, Smith. More than enough.
Now, is she trying to tell me something? Or am I losing my grip? Uh-huh. Well, well, well.
Guess what, ladies?
You'll never guess who we've got staying with us.
Oh, don't say that, Bea. I hate secrets.
So do I. I just hate secrets. And I hate drug pushers! Oh!
I'd rather you didn't do that again.
Why? What are you going to do? Get your copper husband onto me?
Is she married to a cop?
Well, according to this, we are talking to the wife of Detective Inspector Eddie Stevens.
He's the mongrel that put me in here.
Yeah, well, you probably deserved it. Eddie's not too bad as far as cops go.
What? He's a stinking copper,
and
isn't
she's
he?
A stinking pusher.
No, I'm not.
But I can't expect you to believe that, can I?
Well, why would I? You've lied about everything else.
Look, it wasn't my idea. The screws thought it would be safer for me if I lied. Personally, I'd rather have told you the truth.
Which is?
I was set up, framed, if you like, by some very clever people. But like I said, I can't expect you to believe that, can I? I suppose that's why Ferguson dobbed me in. So you'd do a dirty work for her.
Now that is the only thing that's saving you at the moment, Stevens. But I wouldn't relax too much. Because I'll get down to the truth one way or another. Promise you.
Oh, God, Betty. I don't know why you'd bother. It's like trying to renovate a condemned building.
Hello, Mrs. B.
Hello, Mrs. B. You going out?
Yes, love. Wouldn't miss me bingo night.
Oh, I love your dress. It's beautiful.
Oh, thanks, love. At my age, you need all the help you can get. Oh, you don't think I've gone too heavy with the wall paint, do you?
The what?
The makeup.
Gosh, Mrs. B, I didn't realise you had any on.
Rodney, love. If honesty was strength, you couldn't make a sausage roll. Now, listen, you two. Your dinner's in the oven. Now, don't leave it there for too long or it'll get all dried up.
Right.
What time will you be home, Mrs. B?
Oh, about 10, 10:30. Why?
I just wondered, that's all.
Now, listen here, young fella. Oh, Clary, love, I was just
Betty,
telling
you... Betty, why the hell didn't you tell me what day it was? I thought it was my club night. I turned up and there was no one there.
No, love, that's tomorrow night.
No, it's not. It's tomorrow night.
Well, that's good, Pat. You haven't missed out, then.
What?
I said you haven't missed.
No, I haven't touched a drop. I told you, the club wasn't open.
Oh, God. Hey, love, look after him, will you? Make sure he gets his dinner. I've got a rush.
All right, have a nice time.
Yeah, see you later. Don't worry about the babysitters. Come on, Grandpa, time for your bread and milk.
Don't be cruel, Rod. He hasn't done anything to you.
You want a bet?
You took your time getting here.
I'm sorry. I just had to find someone to do my shift. Are you all right?
I'm in prison, Eddie. What do you think?
I'm sorry.
Well, stop feeling sorry for me and just get me out of here.
Look, be reasonable, will you? I'm trying. I haven't stopped trying since the minute you were charged.
Well, if you can't do it, find somebody else who can. I'm innocent, Eddie. You're a cop. Prove it.
Okay, every lead I've had has fallen on its face. Well, it just isn't easy.
Well, it isn't exactly a bed of roses in here either. Do the names Phyllis Hunt and Mary Adler mean anything to you?
Are they giving you any trouble?
Are they giving me any trouble? You put them in here, Eddie. Now they've got your wife.
I'll talk to the governor.
What good will that do? You've got enemies all over the place. That's why I'm in here, in case you hadn't worked it out. I was framed by somebody who hates your guts. Now, what are you going to do about it?
Of course, I didn't want to hurt my parents, and so I said that I was a beauty consultant. I kept them happy.
But why? If they sent you to Privington, they must have wanted you to do better than that.
What's Privington?
A girl's finishing school.
The biggest. A real little snob factory.
Then you're mad. You've had every opportunity handed to you on a plate and you chuck it all in and become a pro.
Correction. To become a highly respectable girl.
Oh. B's right. It doesn't matter what you call yourself. You're still in here with the rest of us, aren't you?
14 days won't kill me. And anyway, I've worked out what I did wrong.
Oh, yeah?
Hello. I'm Pixie.
Oh, Pixie, Randy. Randy, Pixie.
Hi.
Okay, I'll bite. What'd you do wrong?
Well, you think about it. For some strange reason, married ladies are allowed to run from bed to bed and nobody could care less. But if a single girl tries it, all of a sudden she's a whore. The married lovelies accept expensive presents and all that's fine. But if I...